Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be unboxing and reviewing the AverMedia Live Gamer Bolt. Now this device is one of the top, if not the best, external video capture devices to date. At least that's what people are saying. So I decided to pick one of these up and compare it to the Elgato HD60S, which is something that I purchased and reviewed previously and have linked in the cards above. I also wanted to make sure that I got a high-end capture device so I could start recording and streaming the all-new Cyberpunk 2077 game, which recently came out and is the most anticipated game of the year. Anyways, stay tuned and we'll check this video capture device out and see what it's capable of. So, like I mentioned previously, the AverMedia Live Gamer Bolt is probably the best external video capture device that you can buy, and it definitely has a price tag to match that title. This device cost me about $382 on Amazon, and that's the price as of now, while it's on sale. With 4K becoming more mainstream and streaming continuing to become more and more and more popular, companies like AverMedia and Elgato continue to push the envelope when it comes to streaming and capture devices. Now this little device can stream and capture 4K video at 60 frames per second by default, with or without HDR, and at a bitrate of 240 Mbps. It also has one of the highest refresh rate pass-throughs of any external video capture device, and supports 144Hz and 250Hz displays, which means you won't lose as much real-time gameplay clarity that you would normally lose with other capture devices. When capturing or streaming video, this little device does all the hard work, freeing up your PC processing power to do other things instead. This device cost me about $382 on Amazon, and that's the price as of now while it's on sale. Before we get into it, let's go ahead and unbox this thing to see what it comes with. In order to capture full 4K HDR video at 60 frames per second, it's recommended that you're running a 64-bit operating system with at least a processor equivalent to or better than its Core i5 or Ryzen 3. You should also have a pretty powerful video card so you can capture the best quality and at least 8GB of RAM. Requirements for 1080p video are a little less harsh. The device itself measures about 4x4 inches and weighs less than 2 pounds. It's got a metallic and plastic-like frame and feels super durable. It's also got a number of grills and openings to help circulate and dissipate heat, and a minimal design with just a few ports for connectivity. And the bottom of this device is lined with a non-stick rubber base to keep it from moving around. Other than the capture device itself, it comes with one audio connector cable and an HDMI to HDMI cable to connect it to your console or whatever piece of hardware you want to capture or stream. It also comes with one Thunderbolt 3 cable to connect it directly to your PC. Packaged with this device is also a free license for you to install and use AverMedia's own PowerDirector 15 editing software, which I'll just keep handy if I decide to switch from Premiere Pro. You also get a customer support contact card with barcodes that you can scan for various things. And of course, you can't forget the quick start and instruction manual, which may help you get set up and get going. With 4K becoming more mainstream and streaming continuing to become more and more and more popular, companies like AverMedia and Elgato continue to push the envelope when it comes to streaming and capture devices. This little device can stream and capture 4K video at 60 frames per second, with or without HDR, and at a bitrate of 240 Mbps. It also has one of the highest refresh rate pass-throughs of any external video capture device, and can support 144Hz and 250Hz displays, which means you won't lose as much real-time gameplay clarity that you would normally with other devices. Now, when capturing or streaming video, this device does all the hard work, freeing up your PC processing power to do other things instead. It's got two HDMI ports on the back, one for input and one for output, as well as an audio connector and a Thunderbolt 3 port to connect it to your PC. Now, this is where the catch comes in. In order to use this device, you'll need a pretty beefy PC with the latest technology, especially a Thunderbolt 3 connector. Now, I tried and tried and could not get this thing to work on my 4-year-old XPS since I lacked a Thunderbolt 3 connector. I also tried connecting it using a USB adapter and even tried plugging it into my USB-C port on my PC, and it just wouldn't work. In the instruction, it does clearly state that you must plug it into a Thunderbolt 3 port, or it won't even give you the time of day or even acknowledge your system. I ended up having to borrow a MacBook in order to even test this thing out. The unit, when working, lights up very nicely and has some nice LEDs thanks to the installed RGB lighting. It also makes very little noise, even when capturing and streaming intense gameplay. It also does an impressive job cooling the unit and dissipating the heat it generates, which amazingly isn't that much. It's warm to the touch when it's recording, but it won't burn you at all. Now, from a build quality perspective, Avermedia did an amazing job on this device. It's fairly heavy and very solid feeling, and it also has a brushed metal feel to it, and its simplistic design definitely disguises the power it has inside. And did I already mention that I love the RGB colors when it's on? So how does the image quality and video look like that's being captured from this device? My video probably won't do it justice, but it's pretty amazing and has no sign of lag, stutter, or quality degradation, and is almost as crisp and clear as the quality from the games themselves, as you can see from the footage I captured here. Now, I'll go ahead and warn you that aside from needing a Thunderbolt 3 connector, you'll also need a lot of hard drive space. The video this device captures is uncompressed and definitely not small. A simple 5-minute video like the ones in my examples was close to 4 GB in size, and can be even larger depending on how high your settings are when you're recording and capturing. With what's currently built in as capabilities for this device are pretty future-proof, at least for the near future, seeing as though we're still just scratching the surface on 4K video at 240 frames per second. You definitely get your money's worth. However, and this is something to keep in mind, if you don't have a powerful PC with a Thunderbolt 3 connector and or tons of disposable hard drive space, I definitely would not recommend you purchase this device. If you're not a serious streamer or content creator and aren't planning on investing on a PC or Mac with high-end components, then I would also not recommend this device for you, and instead go with one of the cheaper solutions like the Elgato HD60S, which I reviewed previously. Anyways, with that in mind, I hope you enjoyed and found this unboxing and review helpful. If you did, please show me some support by smashing that like button and subscribing. I'll go ahead and leave a link to this Avermedia Live Gamer Bolt in the description section below. On your way out, please also take some time to ring that bell icon so you can get notified when I post new content. Until next time, see ya.